Dear ministers, distinguished conference participants, ladies and gentlemen, I wish to thank the Spanish government, the Spanish Confederation of Social Economy Enterprises, CEPES, and Social Economy Europe for organizing today's conference, which promotes the social economy agenda. Let me confirm my conviction and that of the European Commission that social enterprises are a model for Europe's future. As you know, we recently brought forward a European pillar of social rights with three main objectives: equal opportunities and access to the labour market, fair working conditions, and social protection and inclusion. With the pillar of social rights, we strive for a reinforced European social model and an inclusive and resilient social market economy. This means creating conditions to encourage and support socially responsible and sustainable businesses, which are responsible towards their employees, local communities, and society at large, promoting skills and competence development for their staff, building on their innovative capacities. Ladies and gentlemen, I know that some of you represent a part of economy and civil society which has a unique role in this context. You are committed to promoting enterprises aiming explicitly for positive social impact and which don't put capital or profit before people. You represent enterprises which boost social innovation so as to create sustainable and accessible jobs and to promote civic participation, social cohesion, and trust among local communities. And many social enterprises have proved more resilient to the crisis than the normal businesses. From 2008 to 2014, employment growth in social enterprises in Belgium was 11.5%. Social cooperatives in Italy added 20% of new jobs, whilst in both countries, the number of jobs in mainstream companies decreased. The European Union is willing to pursue and even increase investments in social economy, notably through the European Social Fund. Counting all countries together, more than 1.3 billion euros have been earmarked for this priority. Last year, the Commission put forward a new set of measures to scale up emerging social businesses in the Start-up and Scale-up initiative. I am personally committed to making these new measures strong and effective, as are my colleagues, Commissioner Biankowska and Vice President Dombrovskis. In designing the forthcoming measures in more details, we drew on the input provided by other European institutions and bodies and from the excellent report delivered last year by the Commission Experts Group on Social Economy. Building favorable conditions for social economy and enterprises is a European challenge, and the Commission is ready to help. But many efforts are needed at national, regional, and local levels as well. I am therefore very pleased that many member state governments are represented at this conference and that you are ready to take a firm stance by signing the Madrid Declaration on Social Economy. I wish you a successful event.